Now we'll start the QI session. You can now raise your hands. Center 1269.
I have a question.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello. Yes. Continue.
Yes, ma'am. We also create these types of apps using Microsoft Visual Studio. And can we install these types of apps in our tablet using Microsoft Visual Studio?
Visual Studio is basically for creating the .NET application. And but we are going to create the Android application. So we need not to use the Visual Studio.
Sir, but Microsoft Visual Studio also created these types of application.
Which type of?
It is possible to install in our tablet or not?
No, it is not possible. No. Visual Studio, Android does not support that.
Ma'am, if we create from C or C++.
Android is another operating system which use the Java language to create its application. So, okay. We are not going to discuss about that. C. Yeah, Java.
Yeah, Android implements Java. I mean, we cannot code for Android in C or C++. I hope this answers your question.
Can you explain the term density pixel?
Density pixel is used to define the maximum number of the dots which is present in a particular display area. Means more density means the large number of the dots or the pixels is present in a particular display area. If the large number of the dots are present, so it means the high density. But if the dot screen is defined in a format of the dots
pixels.
And dots are a pixel. So large number of the dots is present means high density. More number of the dots means high density. Have you understood this point?
Screen is divided into small pixels.
Hello?
And if there are more number of pixels, so it is high density. That is, the image is more clear in that.
Sir, if you are trying to install internally this type of apps in which electronics components in tablet, can you explain it?
You are trying to install apps. So you can install in any Android based OS these apps.
Like Wi-Fi and other application is also installed.
You can use USB cord to install.
Using USB, otherwise we want to install internally in which chip?
We will see.
We will see the installation in the next session. Center 1208, Anna University of Technology.
Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Good afternoon, ma'am. This is Nandini from Regional Center of Anna University, Tirunelveli. I have one question, ma'am. My
yes.
question is, there is an already application available in Google that is called Google Chroma for displaying a color in our application. Then what's the use of color resources?
Color resources are basically used to create the static color. Means if you are using declare the resource color resources once, then you can use this color resources in any time in your project, in any file. Hello?
I have one more question.
Yes.
What's the difference between drawable HDPI and LDPI?
HDPI is for the storing the images of the high density. Means some images are not, some images cannot be perfectly displayed in all the type of devices. So high devices is about to store the high density device images. HDPI is used for storing the high density, and LDPI is used for storing the low density images.
1032 Mufakamja College, Hyderabad. Please go ahead with your question.
Sir, my question is that whenever we are creating a resource,
yeah.
So we have to write a Java code for that resource and an XML file also for that resource.
We can create, there are both the possible way. We can create any kind of resource in any possible way. Like we can create either in a Java code, using the Java code, or the XML file only, okay?
So whenever creating a resource, we can write in Java also and XML also. So it is not compulsory to write the Java code?
No, it is not compulsory, because you can either create using the XML file If you are creating using XML file, then no need to write the Java code. But some kind of the resources are used using the Java code for implementing these resources. Like view animation is implemented using the Java code only. Okay.
So next sentence. So whenever sir we do an operation or an add operation or multiply operation, so we have to write Java code for that.
Yeah. At that time you need to write the Java code. Because for implementing the logic, you need to only Java code implementation.
So same as is in the case of activity also. So when we are creating an activity or resource or any of the component of this Android, so we have to write an XML file also.
No, XML file is basically used for creating the resources only. Like if you are declaring in the C or the any language by just writing the string and string name. This is the way is done for the static object that will be the saved at the runtime, and every time we need to run the particular string object by using the Java. But in this Android, you need to just create the XML file, and we can use at the compile time only.
XML file is used to put the layout, put the contents on the screen, just to display the components on the screen, like buttons and text boxes that we have seen. XML file is used to just drag and drop them for implementing the logic, what will happen with each of them when we click, or whatever the internal logic is for that, you have to write Java code.
1195 Goed, Bansal College Engineering, Mandideep.
Good afternoon, sir. So my question is, how is supporting multiple screen?
Yes.
How to support multiple screen?
For the multiple screen, supporting multiple screen, I had discussed that you need to set the screen support property in a manifest file, like the small screen, normal screen, large size screen, or the any density screen. So we need to set that property depend upon the Android version. First, you need to go through those table which I had discussed. Then you will able to implement your screen.
1249 Sri Ramakrishna Institute, Tamil Nadu.
Hello sir, yes. This is Rakesh. I just want to ask whether can we develop an Android app using C++?
Actually, no, you cannot.
You can import your project using the NDK in a Android, but you cannot implement another logic into this.
You cannot write a C++ code, but you can import that using NDK.
Okay, this is the last question. 1205 Mahatma Gandhi Missions College, Noida, Uttar Pradesh.
When I simulate the linear layout program, then I got some errors. How can I resolve the error?
What is the error?
And that is not loading, you are not installing that program.
You are not able to install.
Maybe you not written the code properly. So
go to call log or
go
log
to the
cat.
Logcat and find the error properly.
See the error. Maybe there is some problem in your installation. QI session is over now.